special gun club just started with full support from Libs for Sick Reason. Here's what they're training for. Over the last 8 years, the Obama administration has been fanning the flames of division by creating fear and panic in the LGBT community and other minority groups. So, it was no wonder that when Donald Trump was elected as president that the minority communities would fear the change of power from Democrat to Republican. Shortly after Trump was sworn in, the mainstream media continued to feed that unsubstantiated fear, which eventually turned into paranoia. Now, these minority groups are in an utter state of paranoia and are busy arming themselves, and it only gets worse from there. The liberal agenda has been hard at work for the better part of the last decade, dividing Americans by sex, gender, and race to create chaos. While the majority of this division can be attributed to Barack Obama, the mainstream media is equally culpable for the spread of misinformation. During the presidential campaign, the mainstream media was busy brainwashing minority groups into believing that when Trump was elected, he would begin to round up individuals in the LGBT community and ship them to concentration camps and openly discriminate other minorities. While that cannot be further from the truth, these individuals believed it and now feel that they are fighting for their survival. In an ironic embrace of the Second Amendment, these members of the LGBT community have begun to take up arms for an impending war. Radicalized members of these minority groups have popped up all over the country, and it doesn't appear it will end anytime soon. For instance, membership in the Pittsburgh chapter of the Pink Pistols, an LGBTQ-oriented gun group with branches nationwide, grew significantly after last November's presidential election and then again after a member of Antifa was killed during a counter-protester in Charlottesville this past summer. While there is no argument with anyone in America arming themselves for protection, it is quite another when it is in the spirit of fear and vengeance. 0. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. Over the last 8 years, the Obama administration has been fanning the flames of division by creating fear and panic in the LGBT community and other minority groups. So, it was no wonder that when Donald Trump was elected as president that the minority communities would fear the change of power from Democrat to Republican. Shortly after Trump was sworn in, the mainstream media continued to feed that unsubstantiated fear, which eventually turned into paranoia. Now, these minority groups are in an utter state of paranoia and are busy arming themselves, and it only gets worse from there. The liberal agenda has been hard at work for the better part of the last decade, dividing Americans by sex, gender, and race to create chaos. While the majority of this division can be attributed to Barack Obama, the mainstream media is equally culpable for the spread of misinformation. During the presidential campaign, the mainstream media was busy brainwashing minority groups into believing that when Trump was elected, he would begin to round up individuals in the LGBT community and ship them to concentration camps and openly discriminate other minorities. While that cannot be further from the truth, these individuals believed it and now feel that they are fighting for their survival. In an ironic embrace of the Second Amendment, these members of the LGBT community have begun to take up arms for an impending war. Radicalized members of these minority groups have popped up all over the country, and it doesn't appear it will end anytime soon. For instance, membership in the Pittsburgh chapter of the Pink Pistols, an LGBTQ-oriented gun group with branches nationwide, grew significantly after last November's presidential election and then again after a member of Antifa was killed during a counter-protester in Charlottesville this past summer. While there is no argument with anyone in America arming themselves for protection, it is quite another when it is in the spirit of fear and vengeance. Follow. AP Eastern US at AP East Region. Left to bear arms, LGBTQ gun club pushes back against extremists and stereotypes. Story, up.ws web link. 11:11 p.m., October 23, 2017. 54:54 replies, 167:167 retweets, 289:289 likes. Twitter adds info and privacy. Here is more from AP concerning the increase in LGBT members looking for violent solutions to their political woes. The former pacifist pumped a shotgun at the firing line. Lormax Patton never touched a gun before the trigger warning Queer and Trans Gun Club started this past year. Now Max Patton is among the shooters routinely yelling, "Pull!" and blasting at clay pigeons angling over a moat field near Rochester. Trigger warning members are anxious about armed and organized extremists who seem increasingly emboldened. Their response has a touch of symmetry to it. They started a club to teach members how to take up arms. "It's a way to assert our strength," said Jake Allen, 27, who helped form the group. "Often, queer people are thought of as being weak, as being defenseless, and I think in many ways this pushes back against that. And I want white supremacists and neo-Nazis to know that queer people are taking steps necessary to protect themselves." Trigger warning members meet once a month to shoot steel targets and saucer-shaped pigeons. The 18 dues-paying members are all LGBTQ, many just learning about guns. "I identified as a pacifist really through most of my life," said Max Patton, 37, who has attended a self-defense seminar and now owns a 20-gauge shotgun. On a recent evening, their instructor showed novices how to pull a .22 caliber rifle snugly to their shoulders and how to aim slightly ahead of a moving target. Members cheered when shooters shattered a pigeon or hit a bull's eye. The light mood belies the apprehension that led to group's creation this past winter amid a year marked by politically tinged violence ranging from scuffles at protests to a violent clash of white supremacists and counter-protesters in Charlottesville, Virginia. Zora Gusso recalls the dismal time earlier this year when she began talking to Allen about taking on the gaping hole in the knowledge of people on the left about firearms. "I grew up afraid of guns," Gusso said. "The first time I was near a gun in a house, it was of one of my friends, and I basically jumped back. And that feels dangerous to me in a society where there are so many guns." A dozen shooters in a field in upstate New York does not exactly represent a vanguard of a newly armed left. But the group is not alone. Allen said there is another trigger warning chapter in Atlanta and he has received inquiries from people in about 10 other cities. "This unfounded fear in the LGBT community just goes to show you how powerful the mainstream media is in their reach to create as much division as they possibly can in an already fractured country. Of course, if anyone listened to the misinformation spouted by these significant news networks daily, they would believe that Trump and conservatives were out to get them and come to the conclusion that they need to fight back.